Hey guys, welcome back to some more Clannad. So, in the last episode, we met Kyo Fujibayashi in this visual novel for the first time. Her and Tomoya completely killed Sunahara. He is roasted. He's done for. But yeah, we got our fortune told, and you'll soon get a girlfriend and be happy. Ooh. Sounds like things are going well with him and Nagisa. We are on her route after all. Anyways, let's get going here. A bell rings to signal the start of afternoon classes. I take my seat, annoyed that I'm stuck at this desk for the next however long. Oh yeah, he came to school on time today. Hearing the same sound, Kyo dashes out of the classroom. Yeah, get back to your class, Kyo. Damn it. These shit disturbers. Once again, class is done in an instant. A voice calls out to me right as the period ends, but I quickly realize it's just my teachers. Like a good student, I decide to ignore it. I thought that was a student that was calling his name. It sounded like a student's voice. Ah, he's so persistent. What is it? I raise my head while answering him, a tone of distrust and annoyance heard in my voice. My homeroom teacher walks right up to me. How is this guy supposed to know? Well, I know. He's dead. We killed him in the last episode. I look at my desk next to mine. He's right. Sunahara's not there. Who knows? What? Me? Why? He's not wrong. We are kind of seen with him most of the time. Nope, nothing coming to mind. Oh shit, we're in shit. Where to? Why?
Okazaki.
Did you hear that exasperated ass sound that his teacher just made? Okazaki, come on. I'm not as bad as Sunahara though. At least I show up before lunch. Do you regret not getting Sunahara's ass over here now, Tomoya? Now you're gonna get drilled for it. Oh, what a depressing situation this is. But if it means that I can skip class after this, it seems wisest to just do as he says and look for Sunahara. Okay, I understand. I'll go find him. I turn around and start walking.
Oi, Okazaki! 今からじゃないぞ! 授業が終わってからだぞ!
I pretend to not hear that last bit. Now I've got plausible deniability. And can blame him if I get scolded for skipping out on the rest of the day. This guy's gonna get himself fucking expelled. I'm certain that Sunahara was around during lunch, but I'm not sure if he was around to take fifth period. I slept through the whole thing. That would mean he ran off after telling us he was going to make it big. I don't have a clue where he could have gone off to. I start losing interest in finding him. Who the hell's tapping on me? Who's tapping? Someone is tapping on my back. Oh fuck, who else would it be? I know who it is. From the armpit to the waist. Wait, I missed that. What do you want? Who else makes the wah noise? I turn around just in time to catch the sight of a girl running away. I recognize the music. That's all I need to know. I recognize the figure. Must be the wood carving girl I met yesterday. Is she some kind of pervert? Again? Are you not paying attention to her? I decide to stop walking and see what happens. Okay, this is going on too long. Not letting go of the opportunity, she keeps touching all over the place. Okay, well, hopefully not all over the place. A passing female student can't hold in her laughter as she looks at us. That is my groin. Oh no. She taps there again. So you're interested in that place that much? Squeeze, excuse me. Don't grab it. Surprised by my voice, she loses her balance and falls on her behind. Now she's standing up, tapping lightly on her skirt to brush off the dust. Catching her should be a piece of cake now. Oh my god. You know what? One second, I'm gonna pull up my little walkthrough I have here. So it doesn't say anything about this choice for April 18th, so you know what? I'm just gonna let her go, because I'm pretty sure if we say gotta catch her, it's probably gonna give us more Fuko root stuff. Yeah. And I kind of want to stick with the Nagisa stuff right now. The Nagisa stuff. I still pronounce it like a fucking twit. Yeah, I'll just let her go for now. We'll do this stuff once we get around to the Fuko root. When I turn around, she's already running away. I decide to give it some time and watch as she turns to hide around the corner. She then sticks part of her face out from behind the wall to spy on me. Sorry, but you're too obvious. Just what kind of business does she have with someone like me? Oh wait, I don't think that decision really would have done anything earlier. We end up talking to Fuko anyways, it looks like. Ah well, it's not that big of a deal. Just what kind of business does she have with someone like me? Did I already read that? Well, I don't know. I stick my hands nonchalantly in my jacket pockets. Ah, the thing inside reminds me of the incident yesterday. So this is what she was looking for. Does he still have the knife? Has he been carrying around this knife the whole time? The knife. The sounds of approaching footsteps pull me away from my thought. I raise my head just in time to see if a girl is to... Wait, what? I raise my head just in time to see a girl desperately running towards me. Our eyes meet.
Tombi.
Okay. She hits the window. Game over. Are you trying to take the knife back from me? Excuse me, Fuko? What the fuck was that? What was that? What the fuck? That means yes. Give me my knife back, motherfucker. Hold yourself together. Can you hear me? A complete lack of attention. I push her nose upwards with my fingers, making it look like a pig's snout. And she's just letting this happen? She's unable to resist, and her head is pushed backwards. She jerks my hand away, finally showing me her eyes. I don't know about permanently. I did it because you were ignoring me. Just now? We've been here for like 5 minutes. Stop lying. You jumped at me trying to take that knife back.
Knife?
A knife? You suck at acting. Yeah, get the fuck out of here. You ain't joining the drama club. How about your hand? I smell bullshit somewhere. But it's still got a bandage on it. You literally came at us with that yesterday. Well, then shake my hand. Oh my god, we're doing the same shit. She's trying to endure it. Next, high five. She's still trying to endure it. Very well, boxing training. Oh, this is new. You be the trainer, just pose like this. I make her put her hands up in front of her chest. I'll punch her hands, saying jab, jab straight. So you have to reply with 1, 2. 1, 2. Got it? Are you ready?
Hi.
She closes her eyes. What kind of trainer closes their eyes? Now open your eyes and brace yourself. This poor fucking girl. She looks like she... Oh. Run, Fuko. Run. Her reluctant face is now equipped with round, opened eyes, making for a rather spectacular sight. This is quite entertaining, I'm not gonna lie. Here we go.
Hi.
I'll hit with 100% power. Ready for it?
Hi.
Jab, jab straight. I spice things up a little bit by raising my voice. Bah. Very slowly, I put the knife in her hand. It's a good thing she isn't the one doing the fucking jabbing with the knife in her hand. This could get really dangerous. She's still going at it. Look, I gave you back the knife. Oh, you just now noticed? If you hurt yourself, I'll come and take it away again. Got it? Just be careful so you won't go through this whole ordeal again.
Hi.
Bye then. Tomoya's like, I got better things to do. May as well just frickin' please her and move on. Give her her damn knife back. I say goodbye without looking at her face and start walking away. Wandering around at random is just getting boring. I begin to think about where he could be. Nothing comes to mind. Or are we talking about Sunohara? Where that motherfucker dipped off to? He said he was gonna make it big. He's probably off doing bigger things than you could imagine right now, Tomoya. He's gonna come back to this school a millionaire and rub it in you and Kyo's face. Honestly, I don't really care where he is at this point. I can always get back to class right before it ends. I'll just go where I feel like going. Let me see. Because I want to take all the right choices, right? It looks like we have to go to an empty classroom. I know it might seem a little like, that I'm not making my own choices, but I want to make all like the good choices that get me not only to the through like a certain route, but I want to make all the choices that'll add like extra scenes and stuff. And this guide's telling me there's a bunch of extra scenes if I take specific choices that really may or may not matter at the end of the day, but I kind of want this to be in depth, you know what I mean? The choices that aren't mandatory though, I just pick whatever the fuck. I pick whatever I feel like picking, whatever resonates with me the most. And so far there's been quite a bit of those. There's been quite a bit of freaking options down here I've noticed that don't matter towards the route, they're just there for shits. So it still spices things up a little bit. The theater club's room is right in front of me, but my attention crawls to the side. I peek inside through the glass panel on the door. There she is. Unsurprisingly, a girl is sitting inside working diligently on her carving. Are we back with Fuko again? She seems to be a lot more attentive to her work than the first time I saw her. I guess I won't she get... What did I just say? I fucked that up. I guess she won't get hurt now that she's used to it. Probably. I guess we gotta watch her a little bit more. I decide to keep on watching for a while. I guess these are those extra scenes. Her body, which was moving slightly, suddenly comes to a stop. And she's putting one of her fingers in her mouth. Did she just... Is she licking her bloody finger? She starts looking around relentlessly. Restlessly. And somehow, through the glass panel, she detects my watching eyes. Before her usual wah even reaches my ear, she's already jumped and run away. That was a horrible sound effect I just made. It's more like, wah! Idiot. Rushing like that only makes your wound worse. I quickly enter the classroom. In the corner, the girl is squatting down, facing the wall, with her head resting on her knees. Hey, show me your hand. Not a word from her. She's like, not this motherfucker again. He's gonna take my knife away from me. Again. Is she trying to hide from me? That's exactly what she's trying to do, Tomoya. Just so you know, I can totally see you. I feel like this is another... We're literally repeating the same scenario here, it sounds like. Cautiously, she turns her head around and points a finger at herself. Yes, you. She gets up and runs away again. This time towards the outside of the classroom. Okay, she's running to a different location this time. This idiot, stop running around with an injury like that. Is she running around with that damn knife? I start chasing after her. Where did she go? From the end of the corridor, I can see a teacher walking this way. Oh shit, we've been found out. This guy's in the middle of like skipping class here. He asks after recognizing me. Yes, just looking for someone. A teacher asked me to. You fucking sly bastard. Of course, feel free to since it's the truth. It's like, Tomoya, it's like the half-truth. He gives a suspicious look, and then just walks past me. And then something smallish is following behind him. Like I said, you are way too obvious. I grab her arm. Right after I do, she turns her head to me and puts a finger to her lips to shush me. It might not be a bad idea to listen to her now and be silent for a while. What? They're both being silent. Finally, the teacher makes a turn at the corner and vanishes from our view. A sigh of relief. That went well. Now let's go to the infirmary. Just who are you trying to hide from? Listen, your hand must be hurting, right? Come with me to the infirmary. Again. Bullshit. Stop lying. Show me your hand. The blood must be oozing out right now. That is just... I don't know. I couldn't imagine licking up my own blood. That just... the taste. Did that stop the bleeding? It actually worked? Really? Show me your hand. She raises her index finger in front of my eyes. The blood seeps through the cut, making a narrow red line as a drop falls down. You've been found out once again. Quickly, she puts the finger back in her mouth and starts sucking it. Like a magician, she proudly shows me her finger again. Okay, so it stops bleeding for like 5 seconds and then it starts again. The blood has indeed stopped, but... Do it again, but faster and with more spirit. Maybe yell yay as you do it. What kind of shit is this Tomoya guy into? The blood spouts out. Wow, very nicely executed. She's sucking her finger again. Isn't that cut pretty deep? Like a little kid, she spills the words out. She spills the words out with the finger still inside her mouth. Oh my god, why am I visualizing this perfectly? I guess so. Is Fuko your name? We still don't know. We still haven't been introduced to her name in the visual novel. Oh my goodness. She speaks in third person. Like a lot. Fuko this, Fuko that. Nah, not really. I just thought it may have been your name, but wasn't sure. She turns the other way and starts walking away. Go to the infirmary, you hear me? I say that just to make sure. Guess I was being too meddlesome. She was like, leave me the fuck alone. I'll go to the infirmary if I feel like it. She can just keep on sucking blood out of her finger. But I can't exactly just stand and watch as she puts herself in danger like that, can I? I guess I'll go back. Just as I turn around, I remember something. There used to be a perfect place to nap in the old school building. It was the reference room on the first floor. I'm not sure. I don't think this is a choice that's going to affect anything. Nah. You know what? I'm going to be a responsible-ass student, and we're going to go to the classroom, because those teachers were bitching them out. That's probably best if I'm actually in class, even if I just sleep through it. I'm helping Tomoya. This decision is going to help this guy not get expelled. Two teachers were already bitching him out. Let's go back to class. Even after classes are over, that idiot still doesn't show his face. It's nothing out of the ordinary for him, though, so I won't dwell on it much. I head to the drama club room by myself. As I do, Furukawa catches up to me. Before I realize it, the two of us are walking down the hallway side by side. What's going on, Nagisa? We finally caught up to her, after all of these antics. Furukawa matches my pace, and I can see it's hard work for her, but she's having fun doing it. We're not practicing a play, you know. We're practicing your introduction speech. To her, practice is practice. She wants to practice vocalizing herself and being open. This is so nice. I love this freaking shit. I don't know. I can't really say I know what you're talking about. She's excited, dumbass. She has a friend that wants to help her with the drama club, and she's doing something that she actually wants to do. Hey. Don't you think it'd be a good idea if you decided on what you're going to say ahead of time? Memorization. Well, that's a good frickin' quality to have for a drama club thing. My memory is pretty bad. It's pretty mediocre. I forget shit way too easy. But sometimes I do remember shit. Like Nagisa's favorite foods. For example. I'm not gonna help you decide what to say or how to say it, though. I don't know a thing about drama. If anything, I'd want you to teach me about it. You two are both doing this drama club thing, but neither of you know, like, anything? Where's this... Oh, man. Nagisa, oh my god. A bombshell has just been dropped by the president of the drama club. The president doesn't know. Hey, Furukawa.
Hi.
Why do you want to be in plays? What about them do you like? Okay, that's a good start. Aw, so she wants to feel like she's a part of the stuff that she missed out on. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. In other words, her enthusiasm for being in plays is basically just a desire to work with others in a group. She wants to be a part of something where everyone comes together to accomplish a single common goal. And by doing that, she'd then be able to realize a dream that has gone unfulfilled all this time. That's all. That's the more simple answer. I just like them, okay? Stop interrogating me. Furukawa lets out a small sigh and then presses her hands to her chest. She must have spoken for too long. She seems tired. She's this frail, this fragile, yet she's trying to charge forward. How could you ignore her after seeing that? It is quite endearing, I will say that. I certainly wouldn't be able to. You pass. So I tell her that.
What?
Just use that as your speech, what you just said. It was kind of short, but I get this feeling that you were able to say exactly what you wanted to there.
それは慰めですか?
No, I'm serious. I'm not the kind of guy to beat around the bush. You don't say.
ですよね。たまにぐさりときます。
Like calling her an idiot, and Sunohara an idiot. Yeah, so you can believe me when I say that. Well, it was nice, because she was very, she's very enthusiastic about it when she puts it like that way. When she explains why she wants to do this. The only problem is, whether you'll be able to say the same thing when it's time for the actual meeting. Yeah, hopefully she doesn't just stand there and stutter. You tend to fold under pressure, right? The question that pops into my mind next loops all the way back around to the beginning of our conversation. Then how are you going to be able to act in plays? Furukawa continues to practice for the information session. Perfect. We decide to end it on that note. Her words are clumsy, but I have a good feeling about her tone. It's eager and genuine. Question. I raise my hand, pretending to be a new student.
Hi, どうぞ.
And she just... Nagisa. She's so like... She is very eager. She's cute about this. I think I'm gonna end the episode here though, guys. My voice is getting a little tired here, and I kinda wanna go grab something to eat. I haven't eaten much yet. And yeah. Wait, what is this? What kind of guys are you into? Oh, lovely. I know which option I'm picking in the next episode. Oh, man. We're the fucking goof troops in this Let's Play. But yeah, anyways, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and peace.